Well, let's make some noodles.
Yeah, we're gonna make some chicken marinade with chili sauce and teriyaki, green beans, onion, green lemon that we will use also the skin, the carrot with the peeler and the grater, the garlic, smoked tofu, sesame seeds, coconut oil, lemongrass, harissa powder, cardamom, fish sauce, and the noodles. So first thing we're gonna do, we're gonna roast the chicken. For this I put already the fire at number 7. And I will take, and I will make it little cuts to it. This I will marinate it fast. Normally it's better if it stays one night like this. So I'm gonna do the small cuts in the two directions. Here also. This one I will put here with the paper to dry. And also the other one, I will try to make the cuts not too big. If not, it's breaking down. I forgot to introduce you the piranha knife, limited edition from Henkel's. To cook at home is really incredible. Then here, the chicken already dry. If you want to make the vegetarian version, so you just do the same, vegetarian. Here, then I will add some chili sauce. This chili is not very spicy, it's a sweet one. Also, I like it with teriyaki. Teriyaki is not Thai, but it's okay. Here the pan, it begin to be hot already. Normally, as I was saying, to marinate the chicken is better to wait one night. But in this case, it was not planned to make this chicken today. But it will be okay. Now I'm gonna wait that the pan is really hot and all the sauce is inside the chicken. On the other hand, here I have another cooking pot. And I will add some lemongrass to boil the noodles afterwards. This lemongrass, yes, is from Thailand. One friend brought it. So I don't think it's easy to buy. But I'm very lucky to have it. Even we cover and put fire strong. Well, the pan, it seems to be hot, but I will give it a little bit more. By the way, I will begin to cut the onions, which is the next ingredient going in the recipe. I think I will be on time to prepare it. You know, to peel the onions, I like to cut it in the half, and after I just simulate a little cut in there. So this is allowing me to peel it in once. Without this cut, you see, without this cut, this one is not gonna happen. So this is very fast. You don't need to cry to peel a small onion. This one, it seems to be hot already. So I'm gonna put the chicken to roast there. This sauce, I will keep it for when the chicken is coming out. Not a big deal. There you can see. So now we want this one to dry, so we're not gonna touch it at all. And we prepare the next ingredient, which is the onion. Again, I do this small cut here on top. Normally it works very good, especially for big quantities. So this chicken is already roasting nice. I want it to roast very fast, but to don't cook inside too much. Maybe I can even put number 8. Again, with the onion, is my favorite way to peel them. And the onion, we will just cut it in a big slice. Quite big like this. onion to roll ready. Here you see the chicken is beginning to be ready. So just after that, I'm gonna prepare the carrots. Carrots ready. Let's check, this one is already well roasted. Yeah, a little bit animal, I do a lot of things by hand. And then to avoid these places to burn, where I see is danger of burning of the sauce, I will begin to place the onion. Especially to avoid the sauce to burn. When the onion is on top, it's already giving water and it's avoiding the sauce to burn. See, all on the side. Now, number 8 is finished. Now we go number 6. And we are about already to take out the chicken. This smoke is a little bit spicy, I need to say. It smells like something interesting already. Okay, very good. Exactly, this is what I wanted. Did you see the color? And I leave it there. Now I first place all the onion there. And I begin to grate the carrot also inside. Because this one is needing some water to stop the roasting. Yeah, exactly this. I'm gonna absorb all the roasted flavor from the chicken with the carrot. And this same thing, we can do it over and over in many recipes. We can play with the roasting, and once we understand how it works, it's always successful. The other carrot will go inside. And now I need to rush up to cut the tofu and the green beans. The lemongrass, it looks like is already interesting. So first, I clean a little bit my station. It's good to have a paper to do that. And to work always with the table clean and shiny. Now this one, it begins to smell again funny. I move it a little bit more. It seems like it's burned, but this is especially what we want. So now it can be the moment to roast some chili powder in there. And straight away, I'm gonna add the coconut fat. This one is already spicy, the smoke is very, very spicy. So now put a little bit low the fire. And what I can do in this point, because I need some water, is to add the sauce from the chicken. And as more water is needed. So this one thing, what we are doing, this roasting, is what is gonna give taste to the plate. I can use also a little bit of the lemon of the lemongrass to stop this. And already I will take it out and it's gonna stay everything clean. By the way, it's not in the plan, but I have some rice vinegar that I can also use in this moment. Good. And this one, I will need a container for all these ingredients. Already the green beans, they will come. So I will use the plate. I think it's gonna work, will not be a problem. I will put all this in the plate and keep on aside, because I'm interested to have again the pan ready to be able to roast more ingredients. So if it's more water coming, I can just put it with the lemongrass. Everything it stays in the same family, so why not? So we have in one side the vegetable roasted, we have in the other side the chicken already roasted also. This pan I will like to make it a little bit clean to be able to roast the tofu from zero. So a little bit from water from the other side. Okay, very nice. Very, very, very nice. Now this one I will put number four. To begin roasting some tofu, I will take this slice. Normally, smoked tofu is much better for this, and I will cut it in small cubes, because it's very funny inside the noodles. Just try when you do these kind of things, you keep the block until the end, and make all the cuts more or less from the same size. One escaped. So this one, we're gonna go to roast. And on a side, I will rush up to have some garlic to peel the garlic. Also, normally I cut it in the middle, and then it's much faster. After for the cutting, it's not annoying for me in this case if they are in middles. I don't also take care too much of taking out the thing in the middle, the plant in the middle, the sprout, let's say. Then this one, let's order a little bit, this one out. So this one I will have it in a little bit big chunks to roast together with the tofu. This one at number four, it must take time enough to roast until I'm able to prepare the green beans. Also the green beans, I like to prepare them, to cut them in ones. So I cut all one side. This one compost for the chicken. There is always one hair staying. And the other side. Yeah, quite good. This one we want to cut it quite small. For now I cut margin. I went fast in this part. And then I will put the fire a little bit higher so I can check how the tofu is roasting slow. I will leave it a little bit more. And then I begin to look forward to next task. For example, this one is not heating enough. Also a little bit of salt can be good for the lemongrass. This one, it begins to be nice down there, but still if I don't burn my finger, it's still, I have still margin. Things that we use, we can take out to have the kitchen free. Already the teriyaki and the chili sauce, I keep them on the table because maybe I will want to use it. This one is also, yeah. If you are at home, you can really cook by hand like this. At the end, it's you who will eat it and you will begin to develop feeling in your fingers. Also the tofu, it can go in the fridge. Still not roasting too much. Then what I can do right now, I can put the fire higher, number seven again, and I began to cut the green beans in small. In Thailand, they have a very big green beans. Here, I don't know how to buy them. Maybe they are, but they will come frozen, so it's not very interesting. You will see I'm not adding any ginger in this case. It's not necessary. I don't have ginger today, but we don't need it.
Asian, it will be going to roast earlier. So I'm really in advance, I'm too fast. Now the chicken, you can see there are some parts which are already chopped. I can also break it by hand because the cuts are big. And as you see, inside is completely raw. So in this case, I was only interested in roasting to give some flavor to the noodles, vegetables, and everything together. So this one, sometimes the chicken by hand is better than knife. This is an example. And now we are reproducing a recipe that could be like a street food. So in the street food, to have a good sensation and a good happy ending, you need to work by hand. Just imagine you are walking in the middle of the street with a trolley. Is how this kind of food is being done normally. Exactly, something like that. Just check that there are not too big cuts, and I will put the chicken with the rest of the sauce I still have. This one already is too hot to play by hand. So I'm roasting a little bit the green beans and the tofu a little bit more. The lemongrass stock is already boiling, so I can put down the fire number 3. And this one now will go a little bit higher. I really want for this to go higher. So what happens when we are cooking and we want to roast every ingredient? Normally we have one pan, and we don't have place to roast everything in a pan, because if we put everything together, it's not roasting, it's boiling. And we need to have space for the steam to go. This one, what I'm doing now, is already too tight, is already too much water inside for a good roasting, but it's still okay, because the tofu, it was already dry. So then what we do to cook big is we go roasting batches, we go taking them out like this. I roast first the chicken, I take it out. I roast after this one, I take it out. And in the moment we consider, we can put some liquid to just keep all the roasty flavor on the side and have the pan dry again to begin roasting again. After too much roasting is not good. And here already I have a lot of roasty flavor. This roasting is called, you can Google it between two names. One is a degradation of strecker and the other is a reaction of maillard. There are two different things from the same family. And if you browse this and you Google it and blah, 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 you will begin to understand the basics of the kitchen from a chemistry point of view and why the things are happening, how the things are happening, and how to improve the result between our idea and the reality. So now it begins to look funny. The tofu is already very dry. So especially to give taste to this tofu, first thing we can do is to add the water from the vegetables. Also necessary always with the street food to make a little bit of smoke and a little bit of mess like this. Very good. I take the rest of the vegetables, put down the fire, then I prepare to add the lemongrass stock. Everything out. Switch off the fire there. Now the noodles are arriving. So we'll put two of them for two people. It must be enough. There's a lot of food already inside. And this one, it needs to be touched a little bit. Now I will allow the fire to calm down and for all the heat from the pan and the food and everything to equilibrate. I want to equilibrate the heat before going to the next step, but if not, too much mess. Now we have a stock enough, but it could end being a little bit dry. I also will check the point of salt to don't have any surprise. Intuition is great, but also put your feet in the ground. So we gonna check where we are. It's very roasting. It's not too salty, but it's no problem. It's very good. Now all this sauce on the plate will be great to give it back inside. And also we will do the same with the plate from the chicken. Now we will begin to add the last ingredients. Sesame seeds, they can go inside. And the chicken also. Chicken also. I will open one envelope of fish sauce. Also fish sauce is good inside. And the cardamom, I will wait. So this one just need to be well mixed. It's good to have two spoons for this. So once everything is well mixed, like now, this is gonna be really, really, really tasty. I see it's a little bit dry, so I'm just gonna add some filtered water, because we want to have some stock. Then just cover. We let it boil number five a little bit. When I'm speaking about the numbers, normally all the machines by standard, the same number is doing the same thing. Especially if you are working with electric. After gas, it depends on the pressure of your gas. So we just make this boil a little bit and put everything in place to finish the recipe with the kitchen clean. This one too, teriyaki chili, I tried already and is enough. And as a side here, I would like to have a couple tomatoes with some lime inside. I will prepare the tomatoes. In this point, we can inverse the chopping board to keep working clean. So the tomatoes the same, cut in the middle. Take out the branch. This is beginning to boil, so just need a little shaky and not too hot, number four. Then let's do a fresh tomato salad here. I take the too much skin, so I will just take out the border. Leave the tomato ready. So this tomato is not gonna go inside. It's the side, eh? It's to have a contrast in the plate. This one you need to have a knife which is a little bit sharp for this. Mine is, it seems like enough. So we just cut the tomato in big cubes. And escape rebel tomato. And this one, don't forget to shake a little bit. As here there are many things that still need to cook, it need to boil for a little bit. This is one way to make the noodles. I do it at home because I just do it like this, but there are millions, millions, millions of ways to do this kind of recipes. I encourage you to follow my steps a little bit and to do it as you can, and you will go improving bit by bit. This one, have the tomato already there. I think I finished cutting already. Then I'm gonna put the skin of the lime inside the tomato. We take care to don't scratch too much in the same place.
So better we scratch a little bit and we go checking to don't repeat too much. The flavory part is only the one who have color. The other one, white, it doesn't have any more flavor, so we don't want it inside. Especially from the lemons, it's very bitter. With the limes, it's quite okay. And this one, they don't have bones, and I don't use to use machine for this. I just use my hand. It's good enough. And then I have a problem because I have also already the cardamom oil. It's a very freaky ingredient that I bought in Paris in an event. It's a French company who is doing a crystallized oil. So I will just add it as topping at the end. Now this tomato, it could be called pico de gallo, but it's not pico de gallo. But it's just, we take the same idea to have a side flavor in our noodles. Everything clean. Also the lid. Coconut fat is enough. This one, it deserves to be mixed a little bit. We'll mix again. Olive oil will be great inside here. It's very good. Also, a little bit black pepper. Little bit salt. And I have this bottle of olive oil finishing of making too much bread. I will put a little bit olive oil. So this one, it seems to be ready. With the residual heat from the pan, it will be enough to cook everything inside. So I will just switch it off. Because this pan is very thick and it's keeping a lot of heat inside. Also the microplane is the first tool that needs to be washed and keep safe. Because a microplane which is damaged is going nowhere. It's very important, this tool, each time, don't put it in the sink, just dry it, whoop, and keep it in safe place. I like to have table clean, also the part from the fires. So after we eat comfortable, this one little shaky, it seems okay. So thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed and you're gonna repeat something like this and you're gonna mistake, but you will find other ways to do it. That this is kitchen. So thank you very much for watching and see you next time.